Hey everybody, David and David here from payetteforward.com and upphone.com, and in this video we're going to tell you about some Android settings to turn off immediately. We have a Samsung Galaxy S10 running Android 10. If you have a different phone, different operating system, it might look a little bit different, but the settings are all the same.
Mm-hmm. Everything we're going to talk about today is designed to either take the load off your phone's processor, which is going to speed it up, mm-hmm. or it's going to save your battery life. Both good things, yep. Or it's going to increase your personal privacy, which is also a big consideration nowadays.
Yes.
So we need to go to the settings app to get started.
Right. So to do that, swipe down from the top of the screen there. I have the settings app here. If you don't see the settings app in this menu, just go to search and type in settings. There it is. I'm just going to tap on that. We are in the settings app. First thing we're going to turn off is nearby device scanning.
Nearby device scanning does what it sounds like it does. Your phone is constantly searching for other devices that are nearby that it might want to connect to. It can really drain your battery life.
Yep. So we'll tap on connections. We will tap on more connection settings here. And then nearby device scanning, tap that switch, turn it off.
Next, we're going to talk about how to choose which apps you want to allow to continue to run in the background of your phone, even when you're not using it. Pretty easy to get there. Mm-hmm. We need to enable developer mode, though. So let's do that.
So I'm going to go back to the main page of the settings app and scroll all the way down to about phone, tap on that.
Then tap on software information. Now tap on build number 7 times.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Then enter your PIN or your passcode.
Developer mode has been turned on. Excellent.
All right, so we're going to go back to the main page of the settings app.
Back. So now you'll see developer options underneath about phone. Tap on developer options.
And we're going to scroll down to background check.
Background check.
It's under the apps section.
Under the apps section. A lot of stuff in here. A lot of cool stuff. There it is. Apps.
Background check.
Background check. Tap.
In this list, go through and pay specific attention to which ones have a time amount underneath, because it shows you how long ago that app or service used the processor on your phone. Mm-hmm. This can use cellular data, but it also is just going to drain your battery.
All right.
So if there's anything in this list, especially things that have been using it, like Bixby Voice.
Let's just tap that switch, turn it off.
Turn it right off. Let's go down the list. Anything that you don't recognize in here that doesn't need to be updating in the background when you're not using your phone, like Galaxy Essentials widget. Let's turn that thing off.
Turn it off.
Just turn it off.
Yep.
You can always come back here and turn it on if something doesn't work
the way you
expect to. Next, we're going to turn off usage and diagnostic information. So this is information that's getting sent to Google or to Android developers in the background when you're not using your phone.
Mm-hmm. Burn out battery life. So let's go back to the main page of the settings app. Tap. There we go. And then tap on Google. Then tap on the three dots in the upper right-hand corner of the screen and tap usage and diagnostics. Here you'll see a nice little switch. It's on right now. Just tap it. Now it's off.
Saves some battery life, saves some cellular data.
Easy.
Why not? Next, we're going to talk about turning off ads personalization. Mm-hmm. This is going to just deliver, I know it's anonymous, but still it's sending information about the way that you use your phone to ad networks so that they can send you more relevant advertising.
Yeah, they're selecting data on you, and so you can say, oh, I just talked about biscuits in my living room, and now all of a sudden I'm getting biscuits ads on my phone.
I know, it's weird.
So we'll just tap the back button in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, and you'll see underneath here, ads. Tap on that. Opt out of ads personalization. This, you know, is the settings to turn off video.
Right.
You have to turn this one on to turn it off.
Right.
We're going to go ahead and turn that switch on. Opt out of interest-based ads. You'll still see ads, but they may not be based on your interests. Note, if you clear your cache, you will lose your opt-out setting. Okay. Now it's on.
Interesting. You'll lose your opt-out setting.
Yeah, so if you clear your cache, back here.
That's a load of crap if they're doing that, because they don't need to do that.
Right.
That's crazy. Anyway, the next thing we're going to do is take a look at the location settings on your phone.
Yep, so let's go back to the main page of the settings app, and we're going to tap on location. So the first thing we're going to do is talk about improve accuracy, use Wi-Fi and Bluetooth for more accurate location detection. Go ahead and turn these right off, Wi-Fi scanning and Bluetooth scanning. I've seen actually a lot of posts on forums where people are saying, I turn these two settings off and I save a ton of battery life.
Yeah, this is
because it's just constantly scanning and scanning and scanning and drains your battery.
Yeah, and your location's still going to work. Mm-hmm. GPS is still built into the phone.
Right.
You don't need to have these things on.
Yeah, let's go back here. Next, let's talk about Google location history. This is just going to be a location history of all the places you've been.
Yeah, a little creepy.
It's similar to iPhone significant locations, where it just started saving a long list of all the places you've been. And
right.
It's a little weird for my taste. Tap the switch, and then tap pause near the lower right-hand corner of the screen. And now it has been paused.
Perfect.
And go back to the location settings here. And last thing here is network data analytics. This is like sending data analytics to your wireless carrier.
Who needs it?
Not me. Again, this is just going to be burning your battery by constantly sending data to your carriers. Tap that switch at the top of the screen. Turn it off. Are you sure? Yes. And don't show me this message again. Great.
Sorry, Sprint.
Fix your own network. Yeah. Too late. We're getting bought out. The next thing we want to talk about is restricting background data for specific apps. Like we said earlier, if an app is constantly getting new data in the background of your phone, it can drain the battery pretty quickly. So let's go back to the main page of the Settings app and then tap on Apps. You'll see a list of all of your apps. Just go ahead and pick one. I'm going to pick Bixby Routines.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to tap on Mobile Data. Here you'll see Restrict Background Data. We're going to set this to Always. This way it always restricts the background data the app is using.
Right.
Especially for apps that you don't use very often. Set it to Always.
Yeah, it's going to save your cellular data plan. Mm-hmm. It's also going to save your battery life. It's just about being intentional about which apps you want to download content, like maybe ESPN. Mm-hmm. And which apps you don't need to download content, like maybe your bank or something.
Right. The last thing we want to show you how to do is turn off install unknown apps for pretty much all of your apps. Mm-hmm. What this will do is will block your apps from installing other apps.
From unknown sources. Maybe ransomware.
Yeah. You just don't want to end up with some malware on your Android because some other app downloaded some other app and then avalanche, not good. So let's go back. Go back again. Now we're on the main apps page here and tap those three dots in the upper right-hand corner of the screen and then tap special access. Scroll down here and tap on install unknown apps and pretty much just turn this off for everything. Make sure it's not allowed.
Yeah.
If you see an app that is allowed, you can just tap on it and then you can say allow from the source. If that switch was on, turn it off.
A lot of the times apps will ask your permission if they're allowed to do this. You just tap yes because you're not paying attention, and that's how bad things can happen. Yeah. So just go through. This is a really important security.
Yeah, of course, if you're okay with an app installing
unknown apps.
Yeah, unknown apps. I mean, you can go ahead and leave it on for certain apps, but most of the time you don't want that.
Yeah, you can be surprised. Yeah.
Surprise, here's some malware. Thanks for watching this video. Those are some Android settings to turn off immediately. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Leave us a comment down below with any other questions. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more great videos about cell phones.